Hey guys, so we just finished up with the Christmas party and we didn't get to do some of the things that we wanted to do tonight. So I wanted to make sure that I could come on and share our third week of Advent message with you guys. So I hope that you are doing well and that if you were here with us in person tonight, that you had a good time. But I also want to make sure for those of you who didn't get to join us that you still got to share in the message for our countdown for Christmas in the Advent season. So I want you to think about a beautiful gift under the Christmas tree. I want you to think about gifts under the tree. Have you ever gotten to see them? Maybe some people have them under their tree before Christmas, or maybe you're a house that they aren't there until Christmas Day. Or maybe there are sometimes people who don't have a lot of gifts under the tree. I had heard a story about a little boy who checked under the tree every day, and he checked to see if new presents had been added, and he would group them together, and he would count them, and he would check to see who had more gifts. And one day, he discovered that his sister had more gifts than him. Well, that made him really mad. And he went into the kitchen, and he talked to his mom, and he said, "Susie has more presents than me." And he went into his room and he cried and he closed the door. And you know, he started to not enjoy the rest of the Christmas season because he was so upset that his sister had more gifts than him under the tree. Do you know that that little boy didn't understand the real joy of Christmas? The real joy of Christmas is not about how many gifts that we receive. The joy of Christmas is about sharing what we have with others. John the Baptist is who we're going to talk about a little bit tonight. John the Baptist was sent to prepare people for the coming of Jesus, and he told them to repent of their sins and prepare their hearts for the coming of the promised Messiah. So, what should they do? What should we do? The people asked John. And he said, "If you have two coats, give one of them to someone who has none. And if you have food, share it with one who has none." That's the same message that we need to hear today as we look forward to Christmas. That will help us put the joy into Christmas. And that's what this week of Advent is about joy. If we want to experience the real joy that Jesus wants for us, then we have to learn to share, sharing what God has genuinely, generously given to us. So today and tomorrow, when we light the third Advent candle, the candle of joy, that is the one where we set the candles at Christmas time. When we light that candle of joy, I want you to think about sharing with others and the joy that that brings. You know, many people set out red and green and white and gold candles and lights and pretty twinkly lights to celebrate. In the country of Germany, which is where my family is from, the tradition is to put real candles on the Christmas trees and light them. Those trees look beautiful, all lit with the glow of candles, but it can be really dangerous. And people always in Germany have a bucket of water nearby just in case their tree catches fire. And now most people have started to use safer electric lights on their trees. And many people decorate the outsides of their home with strings of Christmas lights. Some are white, some are different colors. I love going around looking at Christmas lights. Some of them blink on and off. Some of them look like icicles. Some of them are set to music. The reason that people fill their homes with candles and lights during the Advent season is to remind people that Jesus is the light of the world. The Bible tells us about John the Baptist, like I was telling you. John was sent by God to point the way to the light. He came to show everyone where to look, who to believe in. John was not the light. He was there to show the way to the light. He said, "Prepare ye the way for the Lord." His teachings and his actions were to teach us that Jesus was coming, and that we needed to be prepared for that coming. So this Christmas holiday season, don't be looking for what you're going to get. Be looking for ways to help others. That will help you have true joy. And I hope that you can remember that in this week of Advent. And I hope that you have a great week, and I can't wait to see you soon. Talk to you later. Bye.